In this video, I'll show you how you can quickly, easily, and absolutely free turn text into PowerPoint presentations. We'll be using the free ChatGPT and the free PowerPoint. So let's go, my dear friends. And first of all, let's go to office.com, where we can get access to Microsoft 365 for absolutely free. Just click on this button to sign up for the free version, and once you're ready, click sign in. And now you'll be logged in into your Microsoft 365 workspace, where you can use all of the apps such as Word and PowerPoint. And as you can see, we are definitely on the free plan. That's super nice. And next, let's jump into Word and let's create a blank document. And now let me show you how we can access ChatGPT directly in Word. And to make that happen, we'll have to go into add-ins, then let's click on more add-ins, and let's search for GPT. And as you can see, there are a couple of search results, and some of them might require additional purchases. And since we are looking for a 100% free solution, let's use this one called Autopilot. And now the Autopilot button should appear in the top right corner of the menu. That's great. And as you can see, this add-in is free, and it's using the GPT-3 Turbo model. And now, in this field at the bottom, we can type in our prompt. And to save some time, let me open up Notepad, where I've saved this prompt. Please create an outline for a 10-slide presentation about Minecraft. And of course, feel free to adjust the slide number and your topic. So let's just copy it and paste it into the prompt box. And now let's click on that little arrow to start generating our presentation outline. And now let's just give it a couple of seconds. And here it is, a 10-slide presentation outline about Minecraft. That's super duper awesome. And of course, currently we've got only the main bullet points for each slide, and let's say we would like to replace these bullet points with a more detailed information. So let's just ask for that, and once again, let me open up Notepad and let me copy this prompt, replace bullet points with detailed information, and let's just paste it into the prompt box, and let's click on that little arrow. And skadoosh! Now all of the bullet points have been replaced with a more detailed info. That's super nice. And as you can see, we have a plenty of content that we can work with. That's great. And now we can just click on this little button to insert all of this text into our document. That's easy peasy, lemon squeezy. Okay, so right now our introduction slide has 3 paragraphs of text, that's nice, but we might want to reduce some of that text later on. And now let's make sure our presentation has a title slide. And to make that happen, let's insert a new line of text just above the introduction. And let's just type in anything we wish, for example, Minecraft, a game like no other. And next, let's select our title and let's apply a Heading 1 style to it. This will make things easier for PowerPoint when we'll be converting this Word document into a PowerPoint presentation. And next, I like to apply a Heading 2 style to all of my slide titles, so I'll do that for the introduction and the rest of the slide titles. And next, my friends, I'll clean up the text a bit. For some of the slides, I'll leave a couple of smaller paragraphs. For other slides, I'll leave single, long paragraph, and I'll include bullet points somewhere as well, just to see how the conversion process handles all of these different formats of text. All right, so here it is, my presentation text with heading styles prepared for the conversion to PowerPoint. And by the way, adding heading styles to your titles is an optional step. You could try skipping that and see what kind of results you would get. I personally like adding heading styles. And as mentioned before, for some of the chapters, I've left long paragraphs, for some I've kept short paragraphs, and I've inserted some bullet points as well, just to test how it would turn out when converted into PowerPoint. Okay, so the text is ready, and now let's convert it into a PowerPoint presentation. And to do that, let's go to File, Export, and let's look for Export to PowerPoint. And as you can see, it says Preview, so let's just click on it and let's see what happens. Oops, it seems there is a high demand currently, let's just try again. And hooray, now we can see a preview of a couple of PowerPoint themes, that's great. We can scroll to the right to see more themes, and as you can see, each template has its own look and fonts, so pick the one that best suits your needs. We can as well go back and click on this button, See More Themes, and this will give us even more template options. And if we wish, we can click on See More Theme one more time to get even more themes. So let's just pick this template and let's click on export. And now Word says that our slides are being prepared, the content is being summarized, design theme is being added. And yay, the presentation is ready. Let's open it up and let's see the results. And skadoosh, Minecraft, a game like no other. So this is our title slide, that's nice. And right away here on the right side, PowerPoint Designer is suggesting additional slide layouts that we could use for this slide. That's great, but let's look at that a bit later on. So on the title slide, we have a title and a picture on the right. And now let's check out the other slides. So here on the introduction slide, PowerPoint has converted our 2 paragraphs into 2 bullet points. And as we can see in Word, there were 2 paragraphs, and now we have 2 bullet points in PowerPoint. That's nice. However, I can see that some information is missing on the second bullet point. Minecraft first released, and the year is missing. It should be in 2011. Let's just type that in. I guess some of the text might have been cut off while Word was summarizing and converting text into PowerPoint. So please make sure you check your text after the conversion into PowerPoint. And now the third slide looks pretty much the same as the previous one. Of course, it has a different picture, but let's make it a bit more interesting by using the designer. Let's pick a different slide layout, for example this one, where photo is on the right side. Let's click on it, and it will be instantly applied to our slide. That's nice. And by the way, we can always change how these bullet points look like. Let's just use simple circles. Usually, the best practice would be to avoid using bullet points and use smart art or infographics instead. But for now, let's keep on going. And now, one more thing that I haven't mentioned yet is the fact that PowerPoint actually did a pretty good job by matching pictures to the content of each of the slides. So in this case, the slide is all about building and crafting, and perhaps that's why we got this picture of armor with detailed engravings. That's cool. And now, one more awesome thing that we can do is right-click on the picture, go to Change Picture, then search on web. And then let's just search for Minecraft and pick any photo that we like. And this way, we have quickly inserted a new photo that matches our slide even better. And you can always select your picture, go to crop, and adjust which part of the picture is visible. And once you're done, click on crop again to apply the changes. Okay, my friends, let's keep on going. And here on slide number 5, I can see that PowerPoint has done something really interesting. So in Word, we had this bullet list of biomes, or different terrains that you can find in Minecraft, and PowerPoint has converted this list into a smart art with corresponding icons. That's impressive. All of the icons seem to match bullet points perfectly, except the icon for Taiga, where for some reason we have a checkmark icon. I guess everything is always perfect in Taiga. And if we wish to change any of the text, let's just click on the smart art. And here on the left side, we'll see a little pop-up window where we can edit all of the bullet points. And in the same way, we can select any of the icons, go to Graphics, click on Change Graphics, and choose Icons, where we can pick a different icon. Just keep in mind that since we are on the free Microsoft 365 plan, not all of the icons might be available. And let's change that checkmark to something else as well. For example, a dinosaur. And now one more thing. Since this is a smart art, you can go into the Smart Art tab and try applying a new smart art layout. Maybe you'll find something you like. I personally didn't have much success with that, so let's just keep it the way it was. And now let's just keep on going. And on slide number 6, I can only see the slide title, and as I remember, there had to be a bullet list as well. I guess it just got lost somehow in the conversion process. Well, at least a picture is somewhat matching the topic of this slide. And next on slide number 7, once again, we have a smart art. And this time, the information is provided in these horizontal cards with icons. That's nice. And now in the mods and customizations slide, somehow two paragraphs of text are missing. I guess PowerPoint decided that it was just too much text and completely removed it. That's strict. Okay, my friends, and let's say that for some reason you're not completely satisfied with how your presentation looks like. No worries, let's just close PowerPoint, let's get back to Word, and let's try converting Word to PowerPoint once again. You can repeat this process as many times as you wish, and you should see new theme suggestions each time. And this time, let's pick this theme, and let's click on Export. And once again, Word and PowerPoint are doing their magic, and in a couple of seconds the presentation is ready. Let's check it out. And this time, we got this modern-looking theme with a torn paper edge effect. That's nice. And as you can see, each theme comes with its own fonts, so it's a good idea to pick a theme with fonts that you like so that you won't have to change them manually later on. And as far as I've tested, there is no global way to change fonts in the online PowerPoint version. We would have to change all of the text boxes manually one by one if we would decide to change fonts. And as before, we can right-click on any of the pictures and insert new ones from our device, stock photos, or the web. Let's search for Minecraft once again, and if you don't find what you're looking for right away, you can hit search again with the same search term, and you should see new pictures. So let's just pick this one and let's click insert. That's nice. And next, let's try using Designer for this slide. Let's see what kind of layout suggestions we'll get. Let's apply this layout, and skadoosh, we have a new look. That's awesome. And one thing to keep in mind regarding the smart art animations is that it's not possible to animate individual smart art elements. If, for example, we would add a fly-in animation to this smart art, all of it would fly in at once. If you're using PowerPoint Microsoft 365 on your computer, then you can set your smart art to be animated by different stages, but unfortunately, that's not an option on the online PowerPoint. However, if we would apply a fly-in animation to this bullet list, PowerPoint Online actually gives us 3 fly-in animations. That's nice. This way we can animate each of the bullet points individually. So just keep that in mind if you're using the free online PowerPoint. And by the way, let's just select all of the slides by hitting Ctrl A, and let's apply a nice slide transition to all of them. As you can see, PowerPoint Online has the morph transition, that's nice. But let's go with something simple, for example, fade. And let's check it out on the full screen. So I'm really impressed with how fast we can turn Word documents into PowerPoint presentations. First, we've started by signing up for a free Microsoft account, then we've created a blank Word document, then installed the Autopilot add-in, after that generated all of the text, and finally we've exported Word into PowerPoint. Is it perfect? And can it replace human designers? My answer is no, but let's see what improvements we'll see in the future. And let's not forget that this workflow that you've seen today is 100% free. And for some people, a basic presentation might be all that they need, so that's super awesome. And next, if you would like to unlock the magic of PowerPoint animations, then check out this video. I'll see you there.